Okay, so my target population was geriatrics, like all of us. I already knew that assisted living and nursing were going to be out of the picture, so I was like, what is there to do? So I got on Google, started researching maybe facilities or anything that had to do really with older adults. So I came across this facility. It's called Best Friends Adult Activity Center. So it's basically where adults kind of go, or you drop them off and they spend the day there and they just kind of make friends and they just kind of spend the day there just to not be alone at home, because I'm pretty sure their significant others or sons and daughters don't really want them around. So they, this is like, yeah, this is a way for them to be taken care of. So this facility is basically for lower income individuals. Most of them are on Medicaid or Medicare. And for the most part, as I was doing the questionnaires and stuff, they didn't really have, like, the dental priority wasn't where it was supposed to be. They were just like, eh, whatever, I brush my teeth or I don't. So that was kind of concerning to me, and it started giving me ideas of what to ask and things like that. So after I did the research, I contacted the activity director. Her name was Ursula. Well, at first I didn't know who I was talking to because they wouldn't leave me with their names. The person, I think I spoke to like three different people. One was super nice, super sweet. The second one was like, what do you want? And I was like, yeah. Oh my goodness. So, and then the third lady was very professional, very, yeah, we can schedule something in. And they're very hard to get in contact with, especially like through email, because I sent in my questionnaire and I sent in the pre and post, the pretests, and I didn't get any of that. So I had to, the day of the presentation, I had to actually fill out the, actually had to call and get the questionnaire filled out via phone, and then for the pre-test and consent forms, like, I had to do it that day because I couldn't get a hold of them. So after I did the pre and post-test, I asked them, you know, what were the two most prevalent diseases there. She was like, it was blood pressure and diabetes, and then she said that there were members there that used dentures, so I figured, why not talk about dentures. And then because of the high blood pressure medication, I know that causes dry mouth, so I figured that was a good topic to talk about as well. So the day of preparing for the presentation, I didn't think I was going to spend as much money as I thought it was. So the poster board was like about $5, and I got a trifold poster, and I only had one. I only bought one because I figured I was going to use
My trifold was like $10, so I don't know where you got your $5 trifold from.
I think I went to the Dollar Tree, girl. Paid up the Dollar Tree.
Yes.
And then I had to purchase extra toothpaste and toothbrushes because I did, like, it was over spring break, so I can go to the clinic and get more. So I was like, I went to the dollar store. No, I went to Walmart because it's cheaper. They're 88 cents for the toothpaste. Anyways, and then, I bought goodie bags because I didn't want to just give out the toothpaste like that. So I thought it was kind of cute, whatever. So I made the PowerPoint, right? And they didn't have anything for me to connect it to. And when I got there, I was like, it looked sketchy, and it wasn't. But once you got in there, you could tell it was like a lower end type. They didn't really have like computers or TVs. They didn't have anything. It was basically just an empty room with like some old couches that you could tell were like really old. And that just made me sad, because I'm like, they're supposed to come here and have a good time. And they don't really. They had like three tables for like 30 people. So, and then I got there and I realized I didn't have pens for the pre and post tests. And I brought two that were mine, and then I was like, wait, how are 35, 50 people gonna fill this out with two pens, right? So I was like, dang. I was so focused on like getting my PowerPoint together. I was so nervous that I forgot like the little itty bitty things.
I forgot.
And I'm like, oh my gosh. So anyways, John, right? Okay, so I think he had some type of like dementia or like special needs type thing. So I got there like at 9. And my presentation was supposed to be at 9:30, so I can present. So he was really nice though. He was like, do you need help unloading? So he helped me unload and everything. And I was like, do you want to be a part of my presentation? And he was like, yeah, what do I have to do? I was like, well, first can you sign the consent form? And it's basically saying you allow me to collect your data and take your pictures. And the only thing he got out of that was take pictures. So the whole time he was like, when are you going to take my picture? Can we take our picture? And so we were like, and he was kind of like, not creepy, but you could tell he wanted to touch you.
Ooh.
And so I was like, John. And then so John has a girlfriend there, right? And she has like some special needs too. And so I was like, John, why don't we take a picture with you and your girlfriend, right? So I got on the girlfriend's side. He wanted me to stand next to him. I was like, mm-mm. So I went to the girlfriend's side. And I was like, and we finally got to take his picture. And he put it as his wallpaper. And I'm pretty sure it's on his phone right now. So yeah, that was kind of creepy, but whatever. He didn't want to take, he didn't actually want to be a part of like everyone, with everyone taking pictures. He just wanted like us to take, because it was me, Kara, Christian, and Sophia. So he wanted to take pictures of all the girls. So I was like, okay. These were just the people that attended. So I did my presentation on March 16th, and then March 17th, the St. Paddy's Day. So they were having like a St. Paddy's Day dress up. That's why they're all wearing green. This is just more pictures of us. And this is what I use. I just in case the PowerPoint thing didn't work out, this is the PowerPoint printed out. I had the poster board as well, and then I used the dentures and the mouth model, and I handed out pamphlets. Just because I'm the type to want to like hold stuff, kind of read them along. Yeah, because I was like, what if something goes wrong? So I was like, I better prepare for the worst.
Yeah.
That's why I forgot the pants, because I was so worried about like preparing for the worst that I didn't prepare for like the little baby things. This is outside. And they gave us, I guess they had extra hats, and they were like, well, do you want these? And so she just gave it to us. So what I took from this was that there's a lot of underdeserved individuals who go without dental care because they just don't have the means for it. And I noticed that when I was there, there were common things like, oh, well, I would go, but I don't have money. Dentists are expensive. I can't afford it. And there's a huge need for dental care amongst, especially underdeserved older adults. It's just sad. And they're just going to go without it because, I mean, they can't afford it. They're also not taught how to clean their dentures, because I kind of demonstrated how to clean dentures, and they're like, oh, well, I didn't know that, I didn't know you're supposed to take them out at night, because most of them like wear them throughout the whole night. So yeah, the members, when I was giving my presentation, they had a lot of questions, but it wasn't over what I was talking about. So
we kind of had a lot of stuff too, so it's like,
well, yeah, they were asking questions about
peroxide brands. They were asking questions about...
They wanted to whiten.
Yeah, they were mostly concerned about whitening and the cosmetic side of it. Yeah, and I'm like,
that's
crazy. I'm talking about dentures. most of my questions were not related to my topics, but we kind of managed to, like here and there, like Kara would say, like, oh, I know this one, so she would kind of take over. Some of those questions, I was like, oh, I'm not sure. I always ended it with, but make sure you consult your dentist.